Good morning, comrades! Well, there, I said it. Are you pleased now, T362? Well, anyways, hello there, everyone. Dr. ZK, Rosariki here. And, yeah, finally, welcome back to a continuation of Let's Play Vangers, Month of the Road. Yeah, it's been a really long time since I've been telling some amazing freaking stories. So, in this episode, I am determined. I am filled with determination to finally finish opening all the worlds of a chain. And, well, first of all, I'm determined to repair my heavy lady. So, anyways, I'm determined to finally open the passage to the final world of the chain. Oops. And get to the point where I realized how everything in this universe is, well, basically screwed, yeah. Okay, so let's keep going. Yeah, I'm a bit rusty with the controls, so forgive me for like being a little awkward here. I'm kinda lost with the world map as well. But anyways, we got all the artifacts, so we're all good to go. Aight. Now, where the hell is that repair station? Ah, there it is. Come on, what are you doing? Go away! Huh. Some time ago that could have been us. But now it's not us. Now we're this big thing. Now I'm going back to the... what's the name? Incubator. So I could easily teleport to Zipa entrance and show you the Zixin reaction to Mechanical Messiah. I'm pretty sure she'll tell another 5 or 6 pages worth of story about how it's connected with Proto Zeke and stuff like that. I mean, man, that lady, she really loves her stories. What the hell? Come on. Let me... Yeah, very rusty with these controls here. And this world too. So, almost there. And the pass to Necros. And we've passed to Necros. All right, let's fall down here and let's go hear some more cool stories about Mechanical Messiah. Ah, it doesn't open for some reason. Oh boy, I'm about to die in fear. My lazy husband has decided to run a little. I'm already in awe of him as good wife should be. Yeah, I'll just flutter my wings and maybe I'll feel better. By the way, I wonder if you even noticed that I have them. Your senseless jump, I'd rip them, as the latest fashion says, and I can explain why. Holy... That's creepy. Alright. I think we stumbled upon her in her, like, makeup. Or maybe I've just encountered some weird graphical glitch. After the clash happened, the poor softies started digging S-caves to hide for some reason. All the entries to S-caves were built so narrowly that softie couldn't squeeze into their holes with the gorgeous wings that they were so proud of. Then Protozeke came and said, "Salvation will be gained only by those who adhere to the fashion." And he almost fully snapped the wings off the fellow who was right by the side. And that was then he became the latest fashion of the universe. Since those times, we Escape's inhabitants have followed this ancient rule and truly tend to our wings. Aside from us, there's Gira in the chain who is also stylish, but that's another story. You, I had a bit of talk now and I feel much better. As for your messiah, throw it away and keep it out of mischief, my dear. Now go, what's the use of standing still together with this freak? Rude. Alright, let's see if we have arrived in the right cycle here. Now, here's the inventory here. Lie here for a little while. Since our luck is full, it shouldn't get stolen. Alright, now let's see if. Of course. Size problems. What the hell was that all about? That was rude! Bitch. Oh, I'm gonna get you. I'm so gonna get you. It's not even funny. By the by, do we have. No, we don't. Alright, so I'll just hang around until the cycle will change. So I'll probably. Yeah, I'll probably cut this waiting out. Okay, finally, I've been sitting here for like 10 minutes. Alright. Z-Club is coming soon, a pompous competition for those who would contest their right to Proto-Zeke. We started it long ago, as we need to have several daredevils competing at once to get relics delivered to Bizon quickly. Do you wish to stay here and wait for spring time for the riding through Necros? Alright, let's do it. Superb, spring has come and selection of master is coming up. You're a lucky one, Bracer. You're fortunate enough to take Proto-Zeke to Bizon. Remember, there are many who wish to put it in the base, so are you ready for this, Flutter? Of course, Temptress! And aren't I a courageous Vanger? And here it is. Alright. Alright, let's go. I didn't read what she said there. Because I'm. Yeah, because I was tired of sitting here and waiting so long. Oh, come on, really? You're gonna do this. Stupid thing. There. Much better. Alright, let's keep going. Let's keep going. And hope nothing bad will happen. Of course, now that I said that, we're gonna encounter all kind of bad things in our way. Yeah, like this hole. And this Avenger that's following me. Yeah, definitely nothing nice. And of course, if I'll keep drying like that. Alright, I think we're good so far. That should be around about halfway down. And I'm being stupid and making a wrong turn. Alright, lower, lower, lower. Oh, and then we're gonna have an adventurous quest of try and get into B-Zone. Because if you remember, we had some difficulties getting inside that thing. So let's see if this is gonna be the case again. Alright. No, don't fall down. I hope you're happy now. Alright, almost there. Almost there. Can smell it. We're almost done there. And I think I made the wrong turn again. Might have. Oh, right, we're at the bottom now. Of course, I could just go and pick up Messia again and just turn into a beeb and get down there. Hey, you jackass, go away! Nobody wants you, nobody loves you. Yeah, I keep trying to close inventory with escape key because I... Oh, that's for Ponka. Alright! So, let's try this. Success! Hi, Protozix Master! We're just finishing up construction of another exit from B-Zone. A huge lump of clay will come in handy. Let me just extract the Vanger code by Zephra out of this statuette. You know that pile poor thing was baked inside the heap by Zephons? I don't think you feel really bad for them, though. You Vangers don't give a fig about others. You don't have bunches. You're nimble, aren't you? Zephra likes holding the collaborates that Prozik. She always sends several Vangers hoping that that way a load will be delivered safer and faster. I make little profits of this cargo, but I have never made a mistake when staking on a leader who won the Necros race, even without knowing the Zephyrs help us select true Vangers. I see that you tried hard for that, and I will reward you with the key to the last abandoned world. Explore. Mostly lava live there. You see what I'm hinting at? All of us are slaves to Surt. Such is the legacy of our ancestors. Although Zixen's mind is alive, our body serves these underground skunks. Take Surt to Zephra as they alone can distill in a special concentrate. Do you ever think about why only the main escapes need Surt? Chain dwellers prefer to keep mum rather than disclose their intimate secrets to rough creatures like you. And I don't plan on either. Be happy that you have. With what you have, you can get to explore the world of departed bios. Thanks for popping! Yeah. Boots, yeah. We have brought boots sector together. Once it started, it gives me a headache and splitting one worse than one nasty popons give you if you when you read too many of them. Zephra must be scribbling your screes with boots sector. You don't spare my heart, my health, dear heart. I wore myself out to toxic clothing Vangers hanging around with their rusty, harmful gadgets along with them. What did you bring me from Buzina? Nothing special. Did you know that all those symbols and letters used to angle the entrance of B-Zone to give all sorts of useful information? But pilfering Vangers ripped them off, taking them away to their beloved Buzina and their ancient Vanger gods. Bring all back to me and you'll be rewarded. I'll tell you a grave and scary secret. Once the walls of our escape began to shudder and collapse, when I came down I saw a strangely designed mecha stuck in the breach. It was called Wormmaster. It turned out that Nutter Zephra hired some moonlighter to sneak into B-Zone and destroy everything in the hole with toxic, but something failed and the boulder gave blah blah blah. Doesn't fit here. I see you've been to Arcus Noi already. Did anybody send their regards to me? No? Strange. Are you sure you were in that glowing world? A charming little glow worm lives there. We would discuss the meaning of life with him. Gosh, my sides are killing me from laughing. It's time you went about your work. Alright, so we don't have... Alright, so now... Now we're ready, guys. We're ready. We're almost ready, though. Not completely ready, but we're almost ready. We're almost ready to take on the final world of a chain. However, there's always however, isn't it? There's a catch. And for that catch, I have to go all the way back up there. So, plus two, Buzina. Because if I recall correctly, this is the fastest way to teleport to the top of the world. Alright, so here's Buzina. Pass to Necros. So we won Zeknop. Now we gotta pick up our mechanical messiah. If only I can, you know, get going instead of tumbling around indefinitely. Yeah, I should have left that capture rig thing with me. Shouldn't have sold it. Well, would have helped a lot. And yeah. Alright, now let's finally go to explore. Well, here we are on the explore. The only threat here are sometimes terminators and quicksand, and the terminators are being jerks to me, and there's a larva, and let's become invisible. Yes, so now in this world there are two secrets where pieces of mechas are kept. They look like these. Okay, where is my okay, yeah, here we have one piece, wither, a macro spot. Ouch. That was very rude of you. And there is another one somewhere around here. Alright, let's actually turn off the cloak. And where's another one? let's actually engage the barrier. The other one should be somewhere around... Yeah, this thing can't drive for the life of me. And there it is. The second one. And what do we have here? And if I'm understanding correctly, we got all the parts for our... Yeah! We can... we have all the parts for the lawnmower. It's a... Yeah, I almost said it's a warframe that something something. It's a mechos that can permanently fly. And what's this pyramid thing? Oh, come on, say it. Thing. Come on. Approaching Spob's entrance. Use protractor for activation. So... Alright. Let's try. Protractor... Spobsion. And then it opens. Huh, interesting. I am Paraffin. The protractor is on you. You've arrived, that is good. Find the truth here, Wanderer. I am the last specter of the Lost Chain. Do you know about us? We remember everything. We are cognizant of the truth. Our world is a mystery. Everything here is under alien control. Zeros all around. But specters have penetrated into the core of the universe. Perhaps you are an accidental zero wanderer. Perhaps you found the protractor on the road, dropped by a plucky Vangar. I need a reliable mobile unit. The specters are already non-existent in normal sense. Among the zeros, we are infinite. To be more precise, I need an engine on Thrill. I think that the key to the sector of the secret of the Unibank must be there. However, Thrill does not like vagabonds. The enemy dwells there. He's smart and cunning, and all zeros die there instantly. I can't let my protractor to go there. I want to test you. Vanger and Mechas make up a single unit. There are too many of you here, making it difficult to distinguish you from each other. Almost all of you are zeros, even when added up. Prove that you want to be the first. Build a Mechas that no one has ever seen, and then come to me again. Subject. Your function is approaching zero. The absence of a unique mechas doubles the gamma factor in your fail. You are in the epsilon of neighborhood void. Given the maximum admissive prompt, the required result is unique mechas to be assembled with your help. Certain bias store non-functional parts. Theory. Zero cannot become one. If you are one, fulfill the order. If you are zero, you do not exist. 1 divided by 1 is 1. 1 times 1 is 1. 1 plus 1 is 1. 1 minus 1 is 1. I am the only one. And it loops. Well, that's odd. Also, there is a little funny thing you can do, right? That you can do, and I'm gonna do it right now. So, if you like, use the where it is, where's my, there's my protractor spoption, and after the spoption is done, we're gonna open it and now throw away the protractor and go inside. You don't exist, I don't exist, it's all a bluff. dividing you by zero, Vanger. The result is unpredictable. Thankfully, that doesn't result in non-standard game over. Also, notice, this escape here doesn't have a save function. You cannot save in there, not even autosave. And I think I... Oh, no. Now, alright. Let's leave our mechanical friend here. Since our luck is high, nothing should happen to him. And let's pass to... where it was? I think it was in Glorks. We're gonna build ourselves a lawnmower. We're gonna loan all mows. And where the hell are we actually? We're at Girach's lair. Stylish Girach. We have to go down. Alright. Yeah. Well, I really do hope that it's here. But if it isn't here, then we have a chance to open another secret on Glorks. Yeah, that secret is given if you come to Buravchik on unique mechas from a different world. And it could contain something useful too. So let's see. And very odd, because there isn't that much of unique mechas part we've collected. I mean, we only completed the sandal and probably the queen frog, and yeah, alright. I'll wait until we're going to do it. Alright, let's go and see if the lone mover is truly here. And I do hope I don't have anything prohibited on my cargo. Tubura, yeah. Where in the box did you find Boots Sector, you piece of garbage? I thought it was buried forever. An agent once served me, had forgotten himself the 8 mechasis. The Dodger wanted to violate the rules of subordination. Later, he got completely mixed up in his motor pool and went nuts. The General's Bureau gave him a rebuilt wrapper, and now he's shipping mail to earn his pension. That's what extensive push led to. To the Bureau, observing Vanger with extraordinary push. According to the manual, he has access to security level 2 archives. Buravchik is acquainting the subject with the material. The non-disclosure agreement was not signed due to the illiteracy of the subject. Vanger, listen to Buravchik. Put a spare part of Lost Mogi. Prove that you are a warpy and so forth. Yeah, this here Buravchik. Hi there. So, what do you think about Buzina? The Bureau suppose the symbols in the circle are an insult to Glorks. This affair requires investigation and the villain must be punished for their disrespect. Agent, remember, the larva responsible for election of castaways is temporarily residing in the zone of chain codenamed Necros. Give me advice, Agent. The Bureau is planning to set up a potential colony of Arkaznoi for Bureau enemies and my ill wishes. Do you think it will be easy for convicts to escape from there? I agree, it's the right place for them. Audience with Buravchik refused, leave the room immediately. Alright, so what do we have here? Blah 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 blah. Yeah, lawnmower. Alright, blah. Look at this thing. Pathetic. Broken, pathetic thing. However, let's add the star.
Look, it already looks much better. And there is the star we've added. And let's add the Whistler. Ta-da!
Fixed.
So, Lawnmower. Normal Vangers are perplexed by these slip-shod methods. Vangers are used to riding on land rather than messing around in the air. Plus, it has an evil backstory. Rumor has it that at the beginning of time, the horrible soft Vangers pursued our ancestors trying to get to the lava. The only refuge they could find was underground in the ice caves. Another rumor says that there is a whole world of softy anxiously awaiting for a chance to rush in, bringing total annihilation to them. Alright, so we're gonna get this thing. This is my favorite mechas, although as you can see it doesn't have anything in it. And, well, tell you what, I don't really need boot sector and nobody ever gets it. And pilot I don't need either. So it's gonna stay here. So I'm gonna take my Robux. So we're gonna get a shit ton of money from this deal. DLC. And all of the ammunition will go with us. And we're gonna need one extra slot for mechanical mesa here. So, yeah. Alright. Let's trade our heavy lady for our flyer. And let's fly! And here we are flying! Yeah, let's charge our spiral. Yeah, this thing doesn't really look right, Will, but infinite flight, hell, what do you want more, especially on Necros? So, as you can see, this thing flies pretty fast, but we're actually not going to fly all the way there. Let's go to explore, pick up our mechanical messe, and get done with this Wham line thingy. The thing that made me rethink the entire meaning of this and the perimeter universe. Alright, we're going fly low. Because, yeah, flying high will get you this. Will get you eaten by the flies. These are sphinxes or something. Alright, so, come here, Messiah. And, alright. Protractor option? Let's get inside and talk to our specter.
I see you are a Vanger with some smarts. You've proven that you are unlike the others. Perhaps you aren't a zero. Although that's only a lemma. Now go and explore the hostile frill. The origin of both you and me is to be found there. It's an axiom. The protractor will memorize everything and then pass it on to me. Make sure you do not lose it and show it the whole of Thrill. Be alert and don't believe your eyes. Watch your thoughts. If you return whole and intact, we will continue our conversation.
Alright, let's go to Corridor on Thrill, the actually the final world of the chain. but of the chain, yeah. The final world of the chain, and it's, remember Arkaznoi? It's even worse. I'm serious. Alright. Now, here's the thing. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to hell. Protractor, barrier. Hurry. Yeah, this is hell. There are fireballs that will hurt you like hell. This is lava. And some sort of creature skeleton here. Yeah, this is literally hell. This is literally hell here. No wonder everyone is so afraid of it. And we gotta find, a secret place on this world. This is real. Yeah, you see? And those fireballs hurt like hell. They will obliterate your mechas in like matter of seconds. Especially if you're on something like this here. Alright, I think I'm lost already. I think I need to change my direction. Another skeleton, I think. Yes, here it is. Alright, now carefully landing onto this thing and detected new reason. The mechanical messiah is in touch with me. Whoa, hold still. I need to finish this dialogue. Hello, mobile reason. You are on thrill listening to Carmine. We want to save you and your world from destruction. We want to help you. We help all the reasonable. A terrible catastrophe has befallen your world. The reason is dying. We want to save the world. We are kind, rational beings from another world. We cannot come in person as we are different. We know what you must be done to prepare the reason of Univank Freed's -7. /8. You can save your world. We study dying worlds and cure them with help of their own inhabitants. Each world is a treasure. We have studied your world. The situation is critical. Those who live underground and don't move will die soon. It will be hard to save them, but you can do it. They have become dependent on unreasonable beasts that can move underground. The reasonable lose, as they are not eternal. They call their gods lava and dream of catching them. Their desires are correct, but hard to meet. The unmoving are unable to capture their own larva. The longer they live with their disease, the worse their internal destruction becomes. The reasonable can get rid of the larva's evil only by getting hold of them. You are the only chance. Your task is to rid the world of larva. Then the reasonable will be saved. You cannot kill larva. Only their subjects can do that. But you can catch them and take them to the sufferers. By finding the larva, the reasonable will find themselves. After you have saved the reason of your world, you'll have to save yourself. It must be eliminated. But only the one who clears the wall of lava is able to do that. Be quick! Communication terminated. A mechanical messer controls the reality. So, I think you can plus two together and figure out who those kind, benevolent creatures are. But we're going to explore, and finally I'm going to talk about how I think the events happened. How everything is screwed and why everything is royally screwed. Why there is little to no hope for humanity in the perimeter universe. Yes, just to remind you, Vangers take place in the same universe as Vangers. Vangers take the same place in the same universe as Vangers. Yeah, that makes sense. Go, writer Akiki, go. In the same universe as the Vangers go in the same universe as Perimeter. So, be prepared for some amazing cool stories. So, you've come back. Unit of a changed life. That's good. Now listen to my story of meaning of life. You might believe the tales you've heard about the ancient softy and their clash of Chrysopor. This is only half the truth. I, Paraffin, the last Spectre, have been waiting for you to avenge our deceased predecessors. You've been to Thrill and sensed the presence of some alien forces. These are Infernals, the cancer of our world. It's true that there was a creature soup. No one could live through it. And the preserve of the vital energy of the softy spirits apart from us, the Spectres. The Infernals came to the softy spirits in form of infinite mind and conveyed them their devastating knowledge. They were simply manipulating a naive softy. The most advanced of the softy spirits soon scented the treachery, but it was already too late to stop the wheel of history. So they isolated themselves from the outer world and set about learning the universe in order to comprehend the essence of being. That's how the Spectres appeared. The Infernals didn't miss a chance to take advantage of Softy's foolishness and blazed trail that led them to unsparing Chrysopor. Thus, both forms of life were doomed. It seemed as if the Infernals thoroughly plotted the clash and its consequences. We were only left to witness this catastrophe, but we delved into the history of the bunches. By the time of the clash, the Spectres, who were softy spirits, had a spiritual way of existing and thus managed to escape the universal fate. Then came the era of unreason. Since then, we've been waiting and searching. We can only guess the overall objectives of Infernals. But the horror wasn't an accident. It was an experiment on two glorious civilizations, the Softy and Chrysopor. Fungus are the only creatures who can change anything in the fading chain. You can repay the Infernals for their treachery. Do you want to know who Fungus really are? I can't tell you that right now, as it might ruin your destiny. Besides, I'm sure I know the entire truth about you. The Infernals, who have never been seen, keep on steadily destroying the remnants of the Univang's vital force. The creature soup left only very narrow-minded creatures alive, who can just barely resist death. But you and they are all that remain from the past glory and the aspirations of softy spirits. The buyers gather their mind and lie, trying to look viable. It's the creature soup that taught them that. The rest just disappeared in the chaos. The silent bios are dreaming of breaking free from pressures of a lava by having the latter captured and held in their escape. It's all a sham. These miserable creatures can't live without a goal. You must have heard about departed bios, yes? Some fools think that somewhere in the world, deep underground, there lived happy ones who were able to hold all of their lava. That's a lie! Those dummies just pathologically striving for their own death without realizing it. It's self-destruction. But their demise is inevitable, for each new generation of Vangers takes to capturing lava, and they can't stop it. The Bunches are persistently digging a grave for themselves with the help of Vangers. The only way to prevent the collapse of the bias is to reverse the process. In our world, set them up apart. The Bunches want to go on living, but their nature steers against them. You must have already visited the small mystical worlds. I've got a plan to relocate the remaining bias there. This will extend the life of a chain. The chain and the bias are closely related. Have you ever noticed how world changed depending on the cycle of the bias inhabited them? It may look lowly at first sight, but these underground creatures are not that simple. I couldn't explain this relationship for a long time. It's deeply rooted at the moment you are unable to comprehend it. Still, you need to know that Univang is one in it always. Only Vangers can perform the task of resettlement. But you are a rare guest on Spobs, and you are the only one who has ventured on Thrill. At last, the ancient prophecies are coming true. If you wish to extend the existence of your world, and give it some more time to find the way to salvation, then listen very carefully, as I only shall say this only once. Only 7 escapes have survived throughout Lost Chain of Worlds. We are aware of the 4 small worlds which may be suitable for bias to live on. These worlds are Vixov, Cox, Puzina, and Arkaznoi. Although they are not particularly good for such weak creatures to inhabit, this is their only chance of breaking out from under the influence of lava. The bias live underground, and if they adapt to their new worlds, they'll be temporarily free from the mercenary Vangers who deliver the wretched set to them. No doubt, the trials will be hard, and not many will survive, but my mathematical forecasts say there is 1 chance out of 100 for them to do so. The surviving bios will be relieved of the legacy of creature soup, the lava. That means the collapse of the Univark will be deferred. You must have already been employed by howling pathogens who appear in escapes from time to time. These daringers will be our only hope and pioneers of new era. You must populate all 4 worlds that I've mentioned. Do that. Take at least 1 passenger from each escape, which is the minimum required to carry out Paraffin's plan. But mind, the bios won't trust random Vanguard with their units. This aptitude is optional and rational, for life is the basis of being. To earn the trust of the bias and take passenger, you must fulfill some taboo task, which are the missions of the Bunches. Prove that you are worthy servant of life. After they've been sent down to the surface, each passenger will start digging deep into the ground. Here, your task is over, as no one will ever help them besides themselves and the laws of nature. You will not witness the flourishing of life, as that is a very long process. I'll keep an eye on the settlers. I can't wait. When the new bios are composing legends about you, you'll be already far away. I'll guide you to a different world.
So, let's talk about this universe as whole. So, if you remember in my ramblings in the perimeter videos, it all began when spirits, these mystical prophets, engineers, and the other stuff like that appeared on the Earth. They had immense knowledge that seemed to be impossible to achieve by methods of standard science. So, they appeared and gave the world all these technological marvels, one of which were the corridors. The corridors, or passages as they are called here, led the mankind to psychosphere,
And eventually, it led them into the crisis on one end and to the scourge on another. So you see, this all has been planned. The spirits first were deceived by the Infernals. They were deceived by them. They were led to believe that they have gained common consciousness of the universe. However, it all was just a lie. They never were in the connection with this ultimate consciousness. They were fooled. They were led to believe that, but in reality, we were just puppets. And then they realized that when screwed up completely. Then, the whole thing with Scorch came. They realized that they were just, played with. So they tried to save humanity. They really did. So they organized this exodus, although they kinda boosted the process by, this whole scourge infestation, scum vaccine and the stuff I told about in my perimeter videos. So, yeah. But in the end, it seemed that the Infernals actually tricked them again. Because if you remember how Perimeter 1 ended with Infernal's Testament, they tricked them again, and then spirits tricked themselves into believing that they actually found the new Earth, when actually, in fact, they didn't. So, on this end, I can say that mankind is really, really screwed badly. Because as of now, it's been like, 1,000 years since the conflict ended. In the meantime, the events of Perimeter Emperor's Testament were happening nearby. So, this is all post-Perimeter, guys. This is all after Perimeter is complete, after... Maybe it's even after Perimeter 2, who knows? I definitely don't. But what I'm gonna do now... I'm gonna... go treasure hunting. Look, is there the larva the Queen of Gulpdown is? A rumble from Babuzina, so naughty rover. Have you by any chance lost your marbles more than magnificent corals and evil statues? Been seeking your fate among the sand of beasts of Arkad's Neuwanger? Yeah, it was a long, long trip to your doom. But you survived, nimble warrior. Say, Looney, what drove you to suicide? Someone's evil will, I guess. Nobody in his right mind would go there into the lakes of lava, into hell of a chain. My father has given you advice. Don't even get close to passage to the thrill. I have nothing to say, Fita, with my lord. So, yeah, that was kind of difficult. Yeah, we still don't have parts for these mechuses. Centennial. Yeah, so we have arrived to that episode where I saw that everything changed my perception of the chain of worlds. We've been told that it was all an experiment by Infernals, and what's more important, the Infernals are still there, they are still watching, and so nobody is truly safe so far. So what are we going to do about it? Well, first of all, no. First of all, we're gonna get ourselves some sort of Yeah, definitely not this sort of. Maybe this sort of. Yeah, this will do nicely. So, first off, we'll go treasure hunting. We're gonna get all the counselor's items, and except for one counselor item. You might have guessed what item it is. It's, if you didn't get, yes, it's Buravchik. Because, well, if we'll take him, we won't be able to complete. Whoa! This thing is fast! Alright, let's pass to. First, let's pass to Vixov. Because there lies something that I. Well, at least I think there lies something that we stole before. No! No! Go away, shark! Don't bring them wet Kuzo Vox. I see it. So, ow. Whoa, what are you doing here, thing? Alright, where's my protractor? I need to be resized a bit. Oh, come on, I can't pick it up! Are you freaking serious? Oh, finally I got it. Alright, now let's pass to the safest of the secret worlds. Let's pass to Buzina. And you know what, while we're at treasure hunting, we can also go and spread the bios around secret worlds. So, what do you say? Let's do that, actually. Alright, let's find some nice place. Like this here. And... what am I doing here? And leave it here. Ow. Ow, excuse me. I'll also leave a mechanical messiah here. Alright, first let's pass to Fostral. And let's see if this here guy has something to say for us. You've been to the world of Raging Flame, where alien mana dwells in lava. What did the voice tell you, unlucky one? It didn't tell you to terminate me or Lipki, did it? No? There, my scratches can relax. Phew! That's all, Peter. Leave me, I'm busy. Sure you are. Aha! Here are two things we can get. Peep, a clay article shaped like jumble seed. All the Burettes often mistake it for real yet, but anyone caught for forgery is in big trouble. So I'm gonna get this, although it doesn't do anything at all. I'm gonna get Edipod. Yeah. Well, tough luck, you're not going to Podish. You're going to... yeah, you're going to Vixen. Dude. Alright. You. Get out of here. Plus two. Alright. Let's quickly escape to Necros. So, see, I told that passengers burying underground will play a role sometime. And I think that's the digging season for Necros, so let's see if I can get down to what's it called, B zone, quick enough to be able to dig her stuff. What's in here? Void. Like in my heart. On. Glug, glug, glug. What's in here? Nothing. By nothing I mean nothing useful. Glug, glug, glug. Yeah, have a nice swim. And now I'm having a nice swim. Wow, this thing is fast. Like, I'm not used to its speed. I mean, I was used to its speed, but now I'm not. And it definitely doesn't have enough clearance to, like, be stable. Yeah, I think the cycle is going to be over soon. Careful already. Whoa! Yeah. Phew, finally!
Back on the road. Yeah, said I.
I guess that's another reason to buy a copter rig. Come on, I'll have to wait another 20 or 40 minutes until the cycle changes. Alright, let's hope I came in the right cycle. Yeah. Come on, first, shut up, first I'm gonna dig. Dig. I am the wolf and I'm digging a hole. Dig a hole. Digging a hole. Aha! Success! Yes! Success! Oh, the best trail of the Infernals has come from Thrill. Slightly smoke though. Never mind. It's just what the Infernals love. Eaten! I can't even boil you in lava to soften the mechas. Go back soon. They're tired of waiting for you on their own trail. They're using searchlights to look for you. Yeah. And what we have here is Zephyk. Yeah. Right. Yeah. All right. Pass to Buzina. All right, we're at Buzina again. Ow! What the hell? What's your problem, statue? What did they ever do to you? Finally, now we don't have to do anything on Necros other than bring them their larva. So I'm throwing it here too and here too. It should be perfectly safe here. Alright, that being done, let's go to... let's pass to Fostral and try and steal stuff from their counselor. And it's still the wrong cycle. Yeah, that's still the wrong cycle. Alright, so what do we have here? Oh yeah, that's
She's asking to wait for a erection. Actually, I'm going to... let's pass to... where is it? Let's pass to Glocks. See if there is the right cycle there. Yep, that's the right cycle, so let's go and try to find Girach's special item. If it's even here. This stuff often ends up in shelves because Vangers have no idea what to do with it. Also, I do believe Zigatuka will send a mercenary after us after what we did. Alright. My greetings to you, agent. Tell me, is there any vegetation on Buzina which would be good for our competitions? It would be good to surprise our heroes with something special. The Bureau sending you there on a business trip to collect flora. You dodge, have you been to Arkaznoi? Get a couple of those locked light rooms for me next time you're there. Will you? I'm thinking of a new sport for our heroes. They're kinda big, you say? It's a pity. I'll try to think of something else. You brought something from Freel, you nut. Enemy instructions for sabotage our competitions, I guess. Burns been thinking of plugging that passage to Thrill for ages, but can't find the time. I'm getting tired of you, hunk of metal. Yeah. Why don't you just get out? Alright, let's get ourselves a Biborat. And... few of these things. By the way, I haven't seen the most powerful, the most awesome, and the most impractical weapon in the game to here. Although I don't think I've seen. Huh. Really? Ow! What the hell was that for? Now, let's pass to. What the hell? Let's drop this guy on Cox. But I doubt anything will go good here for him. So we have seeded the Vixen and the Cox. And this guy is seems to be out for our blood. Let's not let him have this pleasure of having our blood. And it's nuclear war here, so let's go to Fostril and see if it's already what's the name. No, it's not yet. In the meantime, we can go to Podish and try steal Lipuringa from Lipki. And although I really want my heavy lady back, because this, holy shit, this thing is fast. It's like, turbotastic. And yeah, that's the guy who's after out for our blood.
Let's kill him to make an example of him. Because I don't want any weirdos chasing us. Ow. Aha! Losing stuff already? Oh right, I don't have a mechanical messiah. And I'm out of ammo. Cool. Cool beans, cool beans. Yeah, that's a minor inconvenience. That's a minor inconvenience, all right. Ow. So I'm just gonna say that there are three endings in this game. And yeah, I'm gonna spoil that a bit. The ending you get depends on what you do here. Akros is where the larva is, the queen of plump up. Alright, anything here? Tab dusk, edipod. Right. All right. Let's see here. Yeah. Fear the Reaper. But we won't. And the cycle has changed, so I wonder, will Lipke be angry at me if I'll bring the passenger back to him instead of where I'm like supposed to? Alright, look, you're annoying, would you kindly stop that? Let's see if I can go and dig in Lipke's pockets.
says nothing. Alright. Let's try to dig out Lipuringa, and boy, this is gonna hurt. If, there's gonna be this heavy guy chasing us. Oh, this is gonna be painful, yes. Come on! Yes! There it is! Pass 2... Alright. Let's pass to Boozy 9 and drop this thing off. And drop the passengers while we're at it. And here goes Lipurinka, and here goes the passenger. Yep. Now pass 2. Postural. Alright, we're done with carrying out helipods. And now all we have to do is to deal with Biburats and Zixen. Alright, so... And here's another one. Yeah, I'm gonna show you all this in like time. But right now we have something more to do. So, technically, we have all the treasure we could want right now, except for, I forgot the name. Alright, let's pass to Postral again. But to get that, we'll have to do some serious, what's the thing called? Alright. Hey! GTA4! Weirdo. Now here is a funny thing. Whoa! Alright. The only counselor that will admit that you've stolen his stuff is Palets. Ah, I still remember you. You're a thief and a scab. Sadness has settled in my scratches since you stole my stick from me. I suppose you want to take an elige? You've got it wrong, filthy piece of trash. What will my pod say when they'll find out who I trusted the jewel of Postal to? Get lost, you motor bandit. Bring my stick, then we'll talk. So yeah, stick basically does nothing except just allow you to... participate in erection. And since these cult items have no worth, and we're actually gonna be transporting back to our lawnmower sometime soon, because suddenly alt tab.
I need repair. Yay, thanks. Well, that's unfortunate. Look, I don't know what you want from me. I want you to go away. Or what would be better, to die horrible death in fire and flame and shit. Whoa! Alright, looks like the assassin have caught us. Well, there you go, and you're gonna follow him shortly, if you'll continue acting like that. And I'm almost out of ammo again. But for that matter, let's go past to... let's go past to Glorks. We're going to get our some bigger wheels there. And bigger guns too. And what did you see on thrill, you fired piece of garbage? Did you by any chance hear any voices? If so, you might undergo a physical examination. These hallucinations are dangerous to engine's health. Yep. Alright. Mecha says. Well, they only have rivet beer here, so you know what, I'm taking it. And a factor two. Yep. Right, so... Aha, this is what Urban Abyss about talking about. Says Calibri B battles the blockade, an invention of transmundane beings who assemble it from parts of various machines that survived after the clash. The main component used for ammunition is beeps, primitive insects that live on the surface of the world and serve as medium of exchange for all bunches. Beeps contain many unique chemical reactive substances which allow them to be used as thermal bombs after special high temperature processing. Then, when they are thrown out, the force will explode upon hitting the target. So this weapon basically lets you throw your money onto the wind. Here the most powerful and most useless weapon in the game, Crustest Cannon. Sledgehammer Crustest Cannon, a construction mechanism of the softy used for eliminating geological barriers. It was later adapted for combat, possesses great destructive capacity that no mechas can survive, requires an external supply of bombs. The sector of its production was long ago. Yep. Yep. This is what I want. Now, Q-Pock pile. Buying some ammo for this shit. While we're at it, Shrub, Valorant, Boot Sector, Taboo Task. Oh, we haven't made a Taboo Task here. Oh, joy. Then, you know what? I'm gonna stock full on the missiles, and I think I'm gonna call it quits here for now. Because we still need to find another bit of counselor's possession. So, in next episode, hopefully, we'll be going on to finish the game, or at least get as close as possible to finishing it. So leave a comment if you liked the video. Comments mean much more for me than likes and subscriptions, and I hopefully see you guys soon again. This was Rutari Kiki signing off. Bye bye.